Are you serious? I am very serious. Go to Amos chapter 8. The total solar eclipse of the sun is in the Bible, and it is a warning, and it is a warning for America. And God is saying, you have been rejecting the word of God. You have been fighting against the body of Christ. You have been in rebellion against the spirit of grace. And God is going to send a sign and a prophetic warning upon the land. Now, the Lord revealed to me last year about this time, and I've been sharing it for a year now, that the year 2017 would be a year of great chaos for the world, but a year of great blessings for the body of Christ. So this warning is not for the body of Christ. This warning is for the United States of America. God has used total solar eclipses before. 1918, that came across America. That warning was followed by a flu epidemic that killed nearly 700,000 people, including my great-grandmother. It also brought down the Ottoman Empire. In the year 1133 AD, a total solar eclipse went over England, and the same day it went over England, the King of England died. We have seen total solar eclipses by God in the Bible. Some of them have worked out positive. God sent a solar eclipse on the day that Jonah entered the city of Nineveh and told them God was going to destroy the city. And it happened to be the first day of the 40 days of repentance in the Old Testament called Elul. And Nineveh heeded the warning and repented. Well, this total solar eclipse is coming by the earth again across America on the first day of the 40 days of repentance, just like Nineveh, exact same day, the first day of Elul. But will America repent? Here's the warning. Go to Amos chapter 8, three verses, very important. Amos chapter 8, verse 8, shall not the land tremble for this, and everyone mourn that dwelleth therein? And it shall rise up wholly as a flood, and it shall be cast out and drowned as by the flood of Egypt. And it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord God, that I will cause the sun to go down at noon, and I will darken the earth in a clear day. That's going to happen, folks. And I will turn your feast into mourning, and all your songs into lamentation. And I will bring up sackcloth upon all loins and baldness upon every head. And I will make it as the mourning of an only son, and the end thereof as a bitter day. And behold, the days come, saith the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land. Not a famine of bread, there'll be food to eat. Nor of thirst, there'll be water to drink, but of hearing the words of the Lord. And folks, this is already beginning. Very rarely is the powerful, anointed gospel of Jesus Christ preached in the land. There's a lot of people in the pulpit, a lot of pansies in the pulpit, a lot of cotton candy Christianity, and a lot of padded pew parishioners listening, but there's not a lot of power of God. There's not a lot of truth being spoken. And so it's going to get so desperate. People are going to get so desperate that this great famine that will come across America, to find a prophetic word, to find a fire of the Holy Ghost, to find the preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ. The Bible says one of the signs of the end times, that when this gospel is preached into all the world as a witness unto all nations, then shall the end come. But America has started to reject the anointed, powerful word of God. They've diluted it. They've polluted it. They've excluded it from their vocabulary, from the vernacular of their understanding. Every part of their human existence, every crick and crevice in the human existence of the soul has begun to loathe this manna from heaven and has started to desire the GMO gospel, the imitation word, the watered down, the sin allowing, the abominations that have crawled up into the pulpits of America. God is not pleased, folks. Now, I'm probably one of the funnest guys to be around in the world. All right. Are you serious? I mean, I have more fun than anybody. I have more joy. I'm filled with the joy of God, but I must send this prophetic warning, that this is a sign from God for us to understand. This is what it is. It's a call to repentance, but the Lord is saying to me, we will not repent. He's saying to me, oh, there's people getting saved. We had 38 people saved last night in our live broadcast, 15 during the day and the morning. I mean, they're coming to Christ every day. Believe me, people are getting saved. But there's going to be a famine, and this famine is going to be horrific. And people would literally be searching, running to and fro, trying their best to find anywhere where the anointed preached gospel of Christ can be found. Are you saved? Give your life to Jesus Christ. There will also be physical manifestations from this solar eclipse. I don't know what they are. It could be an earthquake. It could be war. There could be domestic disturbances. I don't know. But I know whatever's going on in the spiritual world will manifest in the physical. Give your life to Jesus Christ. It's getting late. He's coming soon.